Everyone dreams of being the best at the character they choose to bind themselves to in any game they play. Some chase this dream with the same character across different games, remaining loyal to a character in the best of times and in the worst of times. Others instead change their mains every time a shiny new DLC character appears, as they proclaim they will drop their old character for the new one without even seeing their moveset. But no matter how they got there, the best are still the best, and with this video, we're going to talk about the best main for each character in Ultimate's enormous cast. Starting with four of the characters that haven't missed a single game: Mario, DK, Link, and Samus. And if you're looking for some hands-on guidance on your quest to getting better at Smash Ultimate, check out ProGuides.com for on-demand coaching through InstaPro to get you prepared to compete at your next regional. Our new Pro Pass grants you free passes to InstaPro, along with a plethora of exclusive content all posted daily. Check the link in the description to learn more about ProGuides. But with that out of the way, let's start with the original Smash Brother himself, Mario, along with one of the best to ever do it with him across multiple Smash titles, Dark Wizzy. The now 20-year-old has been playing competitive Smash for quite a long time, with his first major being the legendary Apex 2015, where the 15-year-old was already showing flashes of his peaks to come by getting 9th place out of 179 teams. There he outplaced well-known names like MVD, Abadongo, and even Wizrobe, the player who his tag is derived from. By the end of Smash 4's life cycle, Dark Wizzy had accumulated enough solid performances in the game to just barely sneak his way into the top 100 greatest Smash 4 players of all time list at 95th.
Oh, look at the up smash, and Wizzy popping off so much. What a set, dude.
God, Wizzy.
But enough of the past, where Dark Wizzy's Mario was overshadowed by players like Ron and Zenyu. In the present, especially as of late, it's been all Wizzy. Since Glitch 7 back in September, Dark Wizzy hasn't missed top 8 at any of the major events he's attended, which is an incredible feat that shows his incredible consistency. Let's quickly run through this streak of results so you understand why he deserves the title of best Mario main in the world. Dark Wizzy got 7th at Glitch 7, beating ZD, Blazing Pasta, and Mr. E, while losing two close game 5 sets to Tweak and Nairo. He then tied for 5th with Shutone at Thunder Smash 3, defeating MVD and Larry Lur on his way there. Next up was Overlords down in Orlando, where Wizzy fell just short of winning the event, being double eliminated by the exceptionally talented Salem, but not before he 6-0'd Goblin and took a set off of Myron's Olimar. As the PGR season came to a close, he really started turning on the heat with a 4th place finish at DreamHack Atlanta, beating Leon, Cosmos, Goblin, and Suarez, before losing to DeBuzz and Mars during this incredible event. His 5th at Play With Heart up in Canada is the only one that you could potentially call a misstep on this streak, but losing to Pandarian and hitting Canadian boss Ouch shouldn't be held too much against him when surrounded by all of this gold. We then move into 2020 with a 7th place at Let's Make Big Moves, starting his PGR season with wins on Cosmos, Sinji, and John Numbers. Dark Wizzy then brought the absolute heat at Glitch 8, making it all the way to Grands to lose to the eventual champion Tweak, but not before taking a set off him, DeBuzz, ESAM, Fatality, and ZD. There were doubts that Dark Wizzy would be able to replicate that strong of an event, but literally the very next weekend, he proved those fears to be invalid with a 5th at Genesis 7, taking a king's ransom of quality wins over Light, DeBuzz, Mutace, Maymay, and Sinji. And this video is being written before Dark Wizzy is faced with the opportunity to continue on this streak at Frostbite 2020. Which is incredibly stacked with talent, but if he plays as well as he has so far in 2020, the streak should still be alive as of the creation of this video, and not 4 days after when I'm recording, but hey, 17th is still really good. But even if the streak does die, the title of the best Mario main in Smash Ultimate won't be passing through Dark Wizzy's hands anytime soon. The players closest to challenging the Mario King would be players like Anti and Prodigy, but with how hot Dark Wizzy's been playing after already being ranked 22nd at the end of the last ranking season, these players would have to start sprinting through brackets to keep up with Dark Wizzy's breakneck pace, which Prodigy might be starting to do because he 3-0'd Leo, but they both got 17th. This is really weird. Now we head into the Congo jungle for the second character on our list, Donkey Kong. With Mario, the choice of Dark Wizzy was plain and simple, but with DK, we've got a bit more of a challenge because there's no DKs who come anywhere near matching his incredibly clean resume, or even his peaks. Top players like Tweak have dabbled with the monkey, but for this list, we're looking for mains, so with that in mind, the title of best DK in Ultimate right now goes to DK Will from Long Island, New York. DK Will has been competing in Smash events more than twice as long as Dark Wizzy, with his tournament results going back to the days of Brawl in 2009. From his decade-plus career of playing almost exclusively Donkey Kong in multiple Smash titles, it should come as no surprise that he's taken sets off of some of the best in that time, like beating Salem and Mike Hayes in Brawl and Mr. R, False, and Mewtwo King in Smash 4. He's had a ton of solid performances at majors across this time as well, with the two that stand out the most being his 9th place finish at Gommel 2016 in Smash 4, and his first place finish at the 2016 edition of Don't Park on the Grass, where he double eliminated fellow DK main Konga, as well as taking sets off of MVD and Captain L. However, we haven't yet seen DK Will's big break happen yet in Smash Ultimate, despite how much time he spends grinding out DK tech on stream. The best he's done so far came from reigniting that flame from 2016 again at Get On My Level in 2019, with a 25th place finish that included a big win over Mewdace. But his claim over the title is shaky at best, so keep your eyes out for play from Brandon in Canada, Konga from Washington State, and especially Dr. Anus, fighting on his home turf for the summit spot up for grabs at Phantom. We then move on to the third character on the Ultimate Character Select screen with the Japanese Link main, T. The recently ranked 15th best player in the world is one of the few playing Big Link in this game, but he's doing an incredible job at representing what the character is capable of. If you don't really follow the Japanese Ultimate scene too closely, you really wouldn't have a great idea of how strong Link can be in Smash Ultimate, because T's first couple of ventures outside Japan in his Ultimate career didn't really play out too well. The first wasn't too bad, a 17th at 2GG Prime Saga in April of 2019, but a 65th at EVO, losing to Mr. R, then being eliminated by fellow Japanese player Aim, was far from representing T's skill level. But this didn't seem to discourage T at all, especially knowing the fact that he was heading back home to one of the best regions in the world, and a week later he was already back competing and got 9th at Sumobato SP7. He continued attending and putting up good placements at the two main tournament series in Japan, Sumobato and Umabura, for the next few months, prepping to take another shot at the world's best at a big US major. And at Kongo Saga, the first major he finally returned for, T went off. T and his Link shattered the expectations of both his fellow countrymen, who thought they knew the full extent of his skill, and the American players, who only had 2 data points to go off of, as he finished this event at 5th place tied with Gluttony. T's run included beating Zach Ray, who often ended his tournament runs at events back in Japan, as well as beating DeBuzz and Gackt, before being eliminated from the event by MKLeo and Meister. Although I don't think T will have trouble defending the title of Best Link in 2020 unless, say, Salem decides to pick the character back up, but with a 33rd at EVO Japan and 17th at Sumobato SP12, his rank as 15th best in the world looks to be in peril a third of the way into this ranking season. I don't doubt his ability to turn it around with a big showing at an S-tiered Ultimate event, but the pressure is going to become heavier and heavier as we march closer to the end of this season. We then jump over to talk about Samus, and because of their tons of similarities, we're going to bundle Samus and Dark Samus together on this one to give the Bounty Hunter crown over to Quick from Germany. Quick's lack of name recognition like T also comes from the fact that he isn't able to regularly drop large amounts of money required to compete in the most important Ultimate events in the world, which almost all happen stateside. Within Germany, however, he is known as a force to be reckoned with, as he moved up from second best to number one in their region on their latest PR, taking the spot from the Palutena main Light, who dropped all the way down to 8th best in Germany. His results from larger events around him show how this fear permeates to other European countries, with tons of top 4 appearances at events like Syndicate or Vienna Challengers Arena, where his progress further in bracket were stopped by top players like Gluttony, MKLeo, and Mr. R. He has had the chance to come to the United States a few times, however, and it's kind of heartbreaking to see that his best performance, which came at the Kongo kickoff event for players to warm up for Kongo Saga, didn't count towards his PGRU resume. Before Tweak and Riddles ended his tournament run at 5th place here, he cleanly beat Samsora and Bestness both 2-0. Demonstrating the ability to take sets off of these players is great for our perception of who Quick is able to beat, but he needed to carry this over into the larger event later that week, and unfortunately it didn't quite transfer into his respectable 33rd place finish beating Ken while losing to Ned and Wrath. Luckily, with the announcement that Panda Global will be switching over to a ballot system, if something like this were to happen for the Samus main in the 6-month season, balloters may be given the option to boost his placement based on a performance like this, which makes me hopeful that we'll finally see a Samus main crack the top 50 this season. But with his 7th place finish at DreamHack Leipzig in late January, losing to Dark Thunder's Bowser and Light's Palutena, it looks like Quick's number one focus should be defeating his fellow countrymen to maintain his spot as Germany's best player before he turns to affix his gaze once more to claim a spot as one of the world's best Ultimate players. And that wraps up our first batch of characters in our series highlighting the best mains of each character in Smash Bros. Ultimate. Let us know down in the comments which characters you would want us to talk about next. Should we be spotlighting the champions of less commonly seen characters like Isabelle or Little Mac, or instead do you want to hear the story of a big name player like Meister who's turned from low tier hero back in the Smash 4 days into now one of Ultimate's biggest pests? The choice is in your hands, so get typing. But before you do, make sure to subscribe to ProGuides and put those notifications on to make sure you don't miss out on any content on the competitive Ultimate scene in the future.